I'm Frank Melling and I'm here in Valencia, Spain for the launch of the new Triumph Street Twin, which is one of three of the new Triumph Bonnevilles, which are going to form together around 25% of Triumph sales. So this is an important bike for Triumph, and it's also an important bike for the whole motorcycling sector, because this reflects probably the latest but also state of the art in terms of retro. So it's a very traditionally styled bike, but at the same time it's very modern. I've ridden it for 60 miles out in the mountains, and I've got to say I've had a fantastic time. I've had a fantastic time stretching the tolerance of the Spanish police, and I've had also just as good a time wandering around looking at some beautiful scenery and passing some donkeys in fields. So this is a bike that's not only captures the spirit of classic motorcycling, but it's a practical motorcycle as well. So we'll have a look round now and show you some of the key points of the machine. If you've been riding bikes for 5,000 years as I have, and you look at the new Street Twin, you can see that this has got the Bonneville heritage running through it. This is a Bonneville not only in terms of looks, but it rides like a Bonneville. It's got that edge of a Bonneville, and that's its great joy. It's not only classically styled, and it does look like an old Bonnie, but it's also got that same feel, and I guess that's one of the cleverest things Triumph have done with this motorcycle. At the heart of the Triumph Bonneville is a new single overhead cam engine. It's an 8-valve twin, but it's a peach of a thing. It doesn't make that much power at 57 horsepower, but it makes loads and loads and loads of torque. It's making peak torque at only 3,300 RPM. On the road, it's a lovely thing to ride. It's got plenty of get up and go for passing and if you want to have a play, but it's also relaxed in the middle of the rev band. And it feels both very classic and also very modern. And that's why I've enjoyed riding it so much. Although the engine is very modern, a key part of this being 2015 and its efficiency is the fact it's water cooled. Triumph have done a really good job at hiding that water cooling with the fins and so on, but it has to be water cooled to get noise emissions and to get fuel emissions absolutely right, so that it will go through the latest CARB tests in California in particular. So it's a clever compromise. It does look air-cooled, and you can pretend it's air-cooled if you wish, but there at the heart of it you can see that cunningly hidden radiator. Neat job though. When you want to, I shut my eyes and thought, yeah, it is air-cooled, but it's not really. Got a 5-speed gearbox, which is a sweet gearbox, and it's also got a light clutch. So it's an easy engine to get on with. The chassis is very much in keeping with the engine because it handles like a classic bike, but a modern classic bike. So for example, at the front there, we've got a modern disc with Nissan caliper on it. It's a good stopper as well, and it's got ABS on. But the handling is set up so it's a really neutral feel. It's a bike that you think you want to turn into a corner and the bike's already done it for you. So it's not got the edginess of a sports bike, and it's not got the laziness of a cruiser. It handles, in fact, just like a classic, which is what it's supposed to do. Again, it's a joy to ride, and that's something that you keep coming back to. This is a nice motorcycle to be involved with. It's a nice motorcycle to spend a day on. If you would like some more great stories about classic Triumph twins, read Frank Melling's best-selling new book, A Penguin in a Sparrow's Nest. Available now from frankmelling.com for $11.99, including free postage.